Hello everyone and welcome to Learnaholic India. So in today's session we are going to see most frequently asked object oriented programming systems interview questions and answers. Here is the list of today's questions that we are gonna discuss in the tutorial. These are the very basic questions which are asked in the interview. So let's start. The first question is, what is object-oriented programming? So the answer to this question is like this. Object-oriented programming is a type of computer programming that is a software design in which programmers defines the data type of a data structure and also the type of the operation, that is nothing but the functions that can be applied to the data structure. In other words, object-oriented programming is a software programming model which is constructed around the objects. This model compartmentalizes the data into the objects, that is nothing but the data fields, and describes the object contents and the behavior through the declaration of the classes, that is nothing but the method. There are basically main four features of object-oriented programming that are abstraction, encapsulation, polymorphism, and inheritance. Abstraction is the process of picking out the common features of the objects and the procedure. Encapsulation is the process of combining the elements to create the new entity. A procedure is a type of encapsulation because it combines a series of computer instructions. Next is polymorphism, a programming language's ability to process objects differently depending on their data type or the class. Inheritance. It is the feature that represents either relationship between different classes. Next question is, explain the concept of constructor. A constructor is a special method of class that initializes an object of that type. A constructor is an instance method that has same name as the class. A constructor is used to set the value of the member of an object. And these values are user-defined values. A constructor is a special method that is used to initialize a newly created object and is called just after the memory is allocated for the object. It can be used to initialize the object to desired values or default values at the time of the object creation. It is not mandatory for the coder to write a constructor for a class. If no user-defined constructor is provided for a class, compiler initializes member variable to its default values. There are some rules for creating a constructor in object-oriented programming language. First rule is that it has same name as the class name. The next is it should not return a value, not even void. The next question is, what is an object? An object is an instance of a classes. It is the basic unit of the system. An object has attributes, behavior, and identity. Attributes and behavior of an object are defined by the class definition. In the simple words, an object is nothing but a self-contained component which is consist of a methods and the properties to make a particular type of data useful. Objects determines the behavior of the class. When you send a message to an object, you are asking the object to invoke or execute one of its methods. From a programming point of view, an object can be a data structure, a variable, or a function. It has a memory location allocated. The object is designed as a class hierarchies. The next question is, what is a class? A class describes all the attributes of objects and the method. Class represents a blueprint of the objects. A class can be defined as a primary building block of the object-oriented programming. A class contains data and behavior of an entity. Class is a category of objects. The class defines all the common properties of the different objects that belongs to it. For example, the aircraft class can contain data such as model number, category, color, and behavior, such as duration of flight, speed, and number of passengers. A class inherits the data members and behavior of other classes by extending from them. The next question is, can you inherit the private members of a class? So the answer to this question is, no, you cannot inherit the private members of a class because the private members are accessible only to that class and not outside the class. The next commonly asked question is, what is inheritance? Inheritance defines a class in terms of another class. Inheritance provides the code reusability and speed up the implementation time. When writing a new class should inherit all the properties of the base class. The existing class is called as a base class, whereas the new class is referred to as a derived class. The idea of the inheritance implements the isA relationship. In simple words, inheritance is a mechanism in which one class acquires the properties of another class. For example, a child inherits all the properties of his or her parents. With inheritance, we can reuse the fields and the methods of the existing class. Hence, the inheritance facilitates the reusability and is an important concept in the object-oriented programming. There are basically various types of inheritance. Some of the inheritance type are single inheritance, multiple inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance and hybrid inheritance. The next most commonly asked question is, why is the virtual keyword used in a code? The answer to this question is, the virtual keyword is used when a class is defined to specify that the methods and the properties of that class can be overridden in the derived class. Thank you for watching today's session. If you are new to this channel, then subscribe to Learnaholic India and don't forget to click on the bell icon for the latest video updates. If you like today's video, then like it, share it with your friends. Also, if you have any query, then please comment below. Remember one thing, sharing of knowledge is gaining of knowledge. That's it for today. Stay tuned for next video. Thank you.